Sorry, not sorry if the audio's low. It's 5 a.m. I'm exhausted, but let's get into it. Pre-market analysis, we're currently up basically a percent on gold. I've been saying this entire week gold has been bullish. My entire weekly bias was bullish with gold, and we have been bullish. Daily broke structure to the upside yesterday. And now we're currently just pushing to the upside. We do have news today. We have core CPE in 10 minutes and consumer sentiment in 2 hours into, well, an hour into market open. Well, 30 minutes into market open. Typically, we would wait for news to release in order to look for an entry, but depending how price action is looking before 7, we may look for an entry, seeing how what's the first news? Core PCE affects the market. So if news is bearish, we will wait for a deeper retracement into whatever one of our retracement tools. And if price action is bullish, we'll give it some time to play out and develop and look for an entry from there. That's more so my thought process right now. Of course, we are bullish. I think it's possible to target this draw liquidity on the weekly highs. Weekly highs are the same with dailies a little closer, but I still do think it's possible to target that draw liquidity. And if getting into this trade, setting our take profits, we can 100% set a take profit within this 4 hour fair value gap. So we have our draws liquidity kind of mapped out in our mind just in case. We are bullish on the day, so we're going to be looking for a bullish retracement. And apart from that, I'll come back once news releases due to price action kind of just chilling right now. 15. Yeah. 1 hour we retrace into this fair value gap, but we also have this smaller, we have a multitude of fair value gaps below it, so we're just gonna wait and see what price action does. And see how news affects the market. So I'll be back in 20 minutes once price action develops after news. So news did release. News was bearish. So good for gold. But with everything being said, we were chased deeper into this fair value gap due to news being bearish. Still rejecting off this 15 minute fair value gap. I did say we'd want to see a retracement if that happened. Something I would look for extra confluence on this trade in order to possibly get an entry in. I'm not saying enter, I'm saying possibly. Is 1 minute break of structure back to the upside here. So that would make this sweep to the downside, taking out these lows. And the break of structure right here, the upside. Yeah. That's kind of what I'm looking for an entry confluence. And if that doesn't happen, then looking for a deeper retracement down into this other hourly fair value gap, which is a pretty low retracement, pretty deep retracement. So we'll come back once price action starts doing its thing. And we'll see what setup Price provides. So I'll be back in a moment. I'll be back in a bit. So yes, we did get a trade entry in. We wanted to see 1 minute retrace for this fair value gap, validated it, broke structure to the upside, and now price action is doing its thing. So we're going to see whether price retraces, takes us out, or continues to push to the upside. Our SL is below the 5 minute lows. TP1 is at this 5 and 15 minute high. So that's TP1 right there. We'll actually put it at the 1 minute high just because it gives a slightly better risk reward. But depending how price action starts reacting at this level, yeah. So that's TP1, and then we'll mark out our draws of liquidity right now together. How do I? Then we have TP2 at these other hourly highs, right here. And then for our time frame, we'll have TP3 and TP4. We'll have TP3 within this 4 hour fair value gap, 50% mark of it. Bam. And then we'll have final TP at this daily draw liquidity. Actually, that is daily draw liquidity. My bad. I doubt we'll hit this because this is a crazy percentage move, but I don't know. I'm just going to mark it out just for fun because why not? Then TP4 there. That's the least likely to get hit. Nonetheless, these are our draws of liquidity, and we'll come back and manage the position. Actually, hopefully, if we can smack TP1 right now, that would be nice. Where's my phone? Hold up. Uno momento. My pants is falling. So, are we gonna hit TP1? Hopefully. I'm in this position. TP1 did get smacked. So we're gonna close 50% of our position. Bam. TP1 smacked. Gonna set stops to break even now. And then let the trade ride. We did de-risk on this trade for anyone asking. So that is a secured 680 on the day. Price is still pushing to the upside, up 700 currently. Within the trade, stops are break even, so it's a risk-free trade. We have TP2 up here at a relatively decent risk reward, but nonetheless, that's the profit on the day at least. We're gonna continue to let the trade ride and see what price action wants to do. Like I said, we are bullish. And while we're here, I actually want to talk about what I've been doing wrong within my trading recently. And I don't know if this has happened to you guys, but greed. I went in yesterday and I was curious. So I was watching a lot of other YouTubers that use multiple take profits. So I was curious to see, okay, how did they use it? What percentage did they take off at certain price points? And then I went in and back tested myself what percentage I would like to take off at certain price points. And I found just with my own trading strategy, first TP regularly, this is in all trades, 50% offset stops to break even. then let the trade ride. 50% off of the position secures the profit for the day. And on top of that, you know, allows you to be risk-free within the trade. So I liked the idea of securing profit, because sometimes I would have TPs that are like the risk rewards 1.34, and it's like, well, okay, can I have a better risk reward? And then you extend your TP and then you start targeting other draws of liquidity that aren't able to get hit, you know. So that's what I found works for me. I went in and back tested that all yesterday. I have an entire page in my journal for that, and all the like little issues I've been making, little mistakes I've been making, like with impatience and forcing trades. For you guys that's seen the video on Tuesday when I flew back from Nebraska, forcing the trade position. But sometimes you need to take a step back and look at everything and figure out, okay, how do I need to be a little more consistent within my trading? And I needed to do that, because even me to you guys, remember, a smart person learns from his mistakes, but a wise person learns from the mistakes of others. I want you guys to be able to learn from my mistakes, and that's why, I mean, I upload my trades and even my forced trades and all this stuff, so you guys can see, okay, this is somewhat the reality of trading. You know, you have your days where even you go into the market not psychologically well, and you know, you take bad positions. It happens, it really does. But for you guys that are watching, yeah, go in, analyze your trading, figure out what areas you're struggling with, really break it down and understand it, because that's what allows you to get a full context on what to improve. But we're going to come back. Price is still pushing upward. We'll see if we hit TP2. Hopefully we can. If we don't, we don't. But overall, I mean, on the day, we actually have 3 TPs. Realistic TPs. I don't think this is a realistic TP all the way up there. That would be a... I can't mark it. 2% move, I mean. It's possible. It's a Friday. And there's high impact news. So we'll see what happens. I will come back when price action starts moving a little more. But hopefully we can smack TP2. And yeah, I will be back. Bam. So price is now retracing. We marked out the 50% of this fair value gap. This is also a 15-minute fair value gap, so we're gonna see how price wants to react off of this, whether it wants to continue pushing downward or do whatever it does plans to do over here. We do have stops at break even, but you know, just seeing it play out, I would like to see a bullish reaction off of this, validating this fair value gap, both on 5 and 15 minute. Yeah, marked out the 50%. I mean, we do have more news at 7. We did learn from, what was it? I forgot what day it was, but we did learn from one of our losses on the new, wait. One of our losses a while back, whilst trading news, we were in profit and the news stopped us out. And that was due to us not having our stop loss at break even. So, also learned from that. So our stops are at break even. We're going to see what price wants to do here. Whether it wants to start respecting this fair value gap or invalidate it completely and crash to the downside. And I'll be back once price either stops us out at break even, news comes out, or price action starts making a move back to the upside around here. So I will be back once price action is one of those three things. So we are slightly starting to make a push back to the upside. We did We did validate this fair value gap, pushing price back to the upside. Hopefully we can hit TP2 like I said. If so, we'll probably split another half of our position. I mean, that would be the goal, to hit TP2. For extra confidence, I would want to see 5 minute break structure to the upside. And yeah, really continuing to follow overall trend. Our TP2 is point, well, 0.11% away, so we can actually record for a minute and see if we do. I just don't want to extend the recording out too much because we also have the recap. And really, I'm curious to see how, not how, but what price action will do for the rest of the day. You know, if it could even target something crazy like up there. I doubt it, but who knows? We do have news in 15 minutes, so whatever the case is, we are going to come back in 15 minutes and then on the recording in 12 seconds to see whether we see 5 minute break structure to the upside or not. Even though, yes, we did break structure here, but I mean that significant break of structure breaking out of this range to the upside, and yes, we did. So I'm gonna come back in around 15 minutes right before news releases, and we'll see how news impacts the market. Stops are at break even. So news releases in 43 seconds. We're gonna see what news intends on doing. Oh something that's so trippy is I don't get how you look at yourself in the mirror isn't how other people see you. I don't get that. But what, anyway, let's see what news wants to do. Who knows? Maybe if it pushes bullish, we'll be quick. We'll be quick, and if it hits TP2, we'll get out. Like, not get out of the full position, just like if it spikes up. See what news is. I don't know what it would be. Bullish. It's bullish. Of course, enchilada. Of course, chupacabra. Chupacabra. Course. Anywho. I need to go take a piss. But for the sake of the video, we'll sit here for another 20 seconds. We'll wait till the next candle close. Just cause. And then we'll go take a piss. There's no way price spikes up in like 40 seconds, right? Actually, a minute, because you gotta wash your hands. Wash your hands, you dirty. Anyway, I'll be back when price action starts to do a little more. I'm surprised news isn't. I mean, unless it kicks in a minute, it's like, poof. But like, compromiso. Oh, señor, compromiso, señor. Okay, I'm actually gonna take a piss. I haven't even had anything to eat yet. Okay, I'm gonna come back. Have y'all seen Mabu drop? Hold up. Bro, Mabu Loki cook with Favi. Hold up, I'll play in a second. Yes, I want to go take my piss. See, I was gonna wash my hands, but then I had hand sanitizer. So I just used a hand sanitizer. I just thought that would be more convenient. I don't know. I actually got lazy. Hold up, let me play this. Will I get demonetized? Will this video ever get monetized? I can play music, right? Hold up. Le Mabu. Low key. Low key. They cooked, I'm not gonna lie. Hold up. How do you. I won't get demonetized, right? I don't know. Let's see.
Welcome to the hood. If you without you good. Yeah, sit you. Wooed up. Backpacks full of rulers. Yeah, I got a white shooter. And no, I ain't shooting no schools up. Yeah, I'm like real cool. Can I do a hit on a scooter?
No, hold up. Hold. Give it a chance. No, I'm not gonna lie. They cooked. And looks like. Look, they cooked. Don't lie. They cooked. They low-key cooked. I don't listen to a little white boy, but he cooked. He cooked with Bobby. He cooked with Bobby. I'm not gonna lie. I think, do I have to link the video in the description in order for it to not, I mean, I'm not even monetized. Well, I'm 3,000 hours away from monetization. Crazy. That's crazy. People like on YouTube, just like, YouTube's, wow. YouTube's just like, wow. Anyway. Chill. Y'all are tripping. Chill. Chill. Chill, 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 chill. Summit, chill. Chill. I'll give the backstory to all of this. Because, chill. Cause y'all are watching, some of y'all just seen Hub. I was searching up USB Hub, USB Hub. Thank you. I bought the Elgato camera. I needed to connect it to my PC. Chill. And then like, chill. Relax. Just gonna go to Drake's verse on Trance was fire. What was I gonna do? Lil Mabu. Price action doing. Just chilling. This right here. Anyway, I'm gonna sit on for another 2 minutes. How long have we been recording? 3 minutes? That's a long time. Can price action just reach and hit TP2 so we can end the recording and be like, yay, we hit TP2 and then go about our day. What's like 10 seconds? You can't play more than 10 seconds of a song. You got once this candle closes, and I'll end the recording just cause. I'll end the recording right now. We'll end the recording right now. Saves time. I'll see you in a minute, and then we'll be more chill. See? See? We just gracias.
Bluey.
Bing bong.
Spread stopped us out of. Actually, it didn't stop us out of break even. Stopped us out in profit. Money, money, money. But on the day,
on the day. We finish off the day. One hand is buttery and the other hand is normal, so. Finish off the day with $805 in profit. But now let's recap the trade. Do I wish I was still in the trade? Yeah, I do. Am I going to do anything to re-enter the trade? No, definitely not. Definitely not. So, but that's so, look how close we were to TP2. That's crazy. I'm still surprised. Spread stop us out. Pause. Spread, bro. I'm still watching price action right now. I hope it just liquidate. Okay. Let's get serious. Let's get into the recap. What, why we took this trade. So, let's break it down. Overall, price action was bullish. We've seen that throughout the week on our technical analysis, we knew price action would be bullish. So, we knew we were looking for buys throughout the week. It's daily. Weekly, bam, retrace into that weekly fair value gap, pushing price back to the upside. Now what? Hourly. During London session, broke structure to the upside, started rallying, really made today's market structure. New York opened bullish, still pushing price to the upside. Price better not continue to the upside, or someone's going to be gratefully disappointed. Joking. Not really. Then, here we had a 15-minute fair value gap that we were chopping off of, and hourly. News market open, not that, news market open, price came down, was bearish, meaning good for gold. And then this news was bullish, meaning bad for gold. I don't know consumer sentiment, I do know other news with other percentages. But in all seriousness, no, price came down to get these lows, broke structure to the upside on minute time frame. That was our execution. Price rallied higher, hit TP1, chopped for a minute, retraced into the fair value gap. Pushed back to the upside, and then now it's doing its thing. It's doing its thing. Look at that. Anyway, my homeboy texted me. I want to look at what he said. He said he's been cooking recently. So, we're gonna have to see. Oh my gosh. He has 22 affiliates. Can I show this? Yeah, I think. He has 22 affiliates receiving payouts from his TikTok shop thing. That's kind of crazy. On hold, $1,100. Shout out to him, I love him. Anyway, do I think price action's done rallying for the day? Really depending. Am I gonna get a re-entry? No. But also learn from that. Wait, no. Not to force re-entries. So, apart from that, this is how price action is looking. That was a recap for the day. Ended off the day with $805 in profit. Next week, we have no news at all. It is Christmas week. Don't be trading on Christmas. We had unemployment claims on Thursday. They just removed it. That's kind of sus. That's sus. That's I don't know if I like this. This week looks a little too. This is suspicious. Now, this is odd. It's a little good, too good to be true. This is. I don't know about that one. I don't know about that one. I don't know about that one. But yeah, that was the overall trade for the day. I love you guys. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. We are doing a Money Printer series 2. A renewed Money Printer series. See, now I can be fine knowing that, price action just wasn't chopping. We actually got stopped out properly. Where was our stop loss? Like, that's a genuine question. Our stops were at break even, but we got stopped out $300 before break even. I don't know. But nonetheless, that's the trade for the day, baby. I hope you guys have an absolutely amazing weekend. Let me know what other content you guys want to see. I need to put all this together, upload it. Soon I'm going back to see what we did right, see what we could have done better. Even with take profit targets, actually 6 minutes on the recap. We could extend it just cause. Let's see what take profit target we could have done better, let's say. Hourly draw liquidity, would we have hit that? Let's look at a different chart. Dang, we really, okay, wait. Oand is an op, bro. Oand is an op. I mean like opposition. I just said the full word opposition. That's what's up. That's on a real note. Oand is an op. Never mind, I would have waited that to 0.2%. I would have waited that 0.2%. The only time I would, pre-scale out my position is if it's 0.1% away. That's still an op move though. Actually, wait. Never mind. It's not an op move. Oanda is an op chart. I'm gonna be real. Oanda is an op chart. Oanda. Oanda. But I was gonna say we'd take profits, but to be honest, I liked our take profits. Our take profits were valid to me, unless, or someone going mid trade and be like, oh, I guess we're gonna target this high when it retraces back up. No. Target proper draws liquidity. But that was everything. I'm happy with our take profits. Learning to actually take profits at take profits. I don't know why I wouldn't take profits at take profits. That's greed. That's greed. That's 100% greed. But apart from that, now that's the full trade and the recap. I love you guys. Hope to see you. Actually, here, we'll rename this. You thought. Can you see this? You can. For look at my jaw. Why is this inverted? This looks so odd. Oh shoot! Like, I'm gonna get Invisalign. That's what I'm gonna get. Like, I don't look like this in real life, but it's so odd that I look like that mirrored. But that I also, I look the form. Look at this. This is my right eyebrow rate. This is my left out. Okay, I'm stop. I'm stop. I love you guys. I'll see you in the next video. Adios.